Antoine Vermette in his first shootout as a Blackhawk. A chance to win it. Weaving Vermette.
Hello and welcome to another episode of City in the Takes Four Feathers. I am your host, Jim Kress, here to bring you the green, red, yellow, and orange feather from the Chicago Blackhawks. The Blackhawks unfortunately just lost to the New York Rangers 1-0 in overtime. Corey Crawford stopped 35 of 36 shots, and the Blackhawks were 0-for-4 on their power play. But to give you a weekly recap of what's been going on, I'll head it over to the Four Feathers. My green feather, my something good, has got to be Corey Crawford. In his last four starts, he's 3-0-1 with a .969 save percentage and a shutout. Now, in those four games, he faced 132 shots and stopped 128 of them. Four goals through four games, not too shabby. My yellow feather, unfortunately, what brings caution is Tavo's playing time for the next game. Now, Tavo Teravainen had a fantastic game against the New York Rangers. He drew two penalties. He was the only one who could get the puck over the line during power plays for zone entries. And he was overall, with Brandon Saad, a very, very good offensive producer. Unfortunately, in overtime, he missed his coverage on Brassard and it led to the game-winning shot in OT past Crawford. It looks like Joel Quenneville in his press conference remarks was saying he really liked the game of Teravainen and the way he's come along. Something else that throws caution into the wind is Trevor Van Riemsdyk. TVR will not skate until next week on his rehab assignment in Rockford with the Ice Hogs. That means more time on ice for Michael Roosevelt and less time for Trevor Van Riemsdyk to recover and adapt back to an NHL playing style when he returns to ice. The red, the stop immediately, the bad, the very not good, has been the power play. The Blackhawks are 0 for their last 15 on their power play attempts. And it really comes down to their zone entries. They haven't been able to set up, well, first off, they haven't been able to win a faceoff in the offensive zone and set up and keep control of the puck in their zone. This has led to constantly going back and retrieving the puck 200 feet away from the play, and it's caused a very, very stagnant offense. Of all of these statistical oddities, I believe this one might be the most odd I've ever brought to you. In their last nine losses without Patrick Kane playing for them, the Blackhawks have been shut out in six of them. So in six of their last nine losses, they were shut out without Patrick Kane. This goes to show the extent of what he does for this team and the type of production he can bring. Truly, he would have been the MVP in the NHL this year. Thank you again for tuning in to this week's Four Feathers. Be sure to like us on Facebook and share our articles. You can also follow us on Twitter at City on the Take and myself at Jim Kress Jr. Thank you and go Hawks.